Well, hey there! Welcome to my channel. My name is Alexander Myung. If you don't know who I am an octavist, believe it or not. I sing for the Sierra Linda Master Chorale, who will make their in-person debut in this November, as well as La Sierra University's Chamber Choir. Now, today, as you might have noticed by my title, it's the 10 best basses of all time. Now, this is just my own opinion, so don't take it to heart what I've chosen, but this is my list that I've made. Of course, there are three categories that I've chosen from because they stand out the most, and that of course is a cappella, Southern Gospel, and choir. And so out of those three categories that I've all listened to over the years, I've decided to choose 10 that I think are the best. And remember, this is very subjective, and if your list differs from mine, that's perfectly fine. Let's jump right into it. Number 10, Jeff Castellucci. He's the bass for Voice Play, and they're an a cappella group. They're really talented, but especially Jeff. His voice, awesome. Of course, he's a very versatile singer, and he actually does multi-track videos with himself, just singing everything. He has an incredible range with his subharmonic notes, which he uses all the time in his videos and songs. You can hear some of them right here.
I have crossed the horizon to find you.
He's been the poster boy for low notes for the past couple of years, because he really stands out for it going as low as possible with still amazing bass, and that's partly because of his amazing mixing of his audio. And that's another factor of why he's pretty good, is because he knows how to mix his bass. Sometimes a cappella bassists don't know how to mix their own audio, and that causes some problems. But Jeff is a master of mastering EQ. That was a mouthful to say. Anyways, Jeff, number 10. So why is he at number 10? Well, that's because we have so many singers that I believe are at a higher level. But if you want to listen to more of Jeff, you can check out his Oogie Boogie Man. That's probably his most famous. Or Moana Medley, which I enjoyed the most. Number 9, Vladimir Miller. Now, when we talk about a voice being heavy or having weight, this is the guy that comes to my mind all the time. You can hear it right here. He's done marvelous work solo as well as in choirs, and he's one of the people that's brought octavism to another level of exposure. I actually interviewed Vladimir Miller this past year in 2020. You can check that out on my channel. Some songs that you should check out if you're going to listen to Vladimir Miller are Do Not Reject Me in My Old Age by Chestnikov. And his rendition of Ave Maria with two other basso profundo. Number 8, Avi Kaplan. Now, I can't make a list without including Avi Kaplan. He was the bass for Pentatonix for a long time until he left in 2017 to pursue his solo work. Avi is one of the few a cappella bassists to have his start in choir. Now, I'm not just saying, you know, the college a cappella groups. I'm talking about real, honest to goodness, choir. You can actually see that here. And I'd go as far as to say that's why he has such good breath control and resonance as an a cappella bass. One of the factors that I always put into when I'm listening to a bass is listening in three different factors. Number one is listening with my high quality headphones. Boom. Number two, listening with my JBL speaker, and this eliminates all of the subwoofer qualities of a voice. And number three, listening straight off of, you know, like a phone. Nani? And what this does is it outfactors all of the bass altogether, and you just hear with the full resonances. Obvious, really consistent with his sound, and the mixing on his audio as an acapella bass is pretty good. It's pretty realistic to his actual sound. If you want to listen to some of Avi's bass, check out Can't Help Falling in Love, the rendition by Pentatonix. As well as their version, or actually original song, Natural Disaster. Number 7, Alexis Lukianov. As a person, he's one of my favorites. He's been one of my biggest supporters in my Octavism journey. As a singer though, he's absolutely monstrous. But don't let his speaking voice fool you.
My name is Alex Lukianov, and I came here for treatment.
This guy is a beast. He wasn't always this monstrous and scary sounding though. He's made leaps and bounds as far as his sound goes, which goes to show that there is no age limit for improvement. If you want to check out some of his more awesome works, check out his solo in Memory Eternal by the Petrom Choir. That is crazy. Number 6, Tim Riley. Gold City was one of the first groups I ever listened to as far as like singing with awesome bass goes, and one of the first songs I ever listened to was, you know, that one that goes, God's building a church. It's gonna march like a mighty army. Now, Tim Riley has massive cut, and what that means is his voice just goes straight through, and you have to in Southern Gospel in order to be heard over all of those various instruments playing. You know, you have the drums and the actual bass or guitar, and that can actually drown out the sound of a singer pretty well. So that's why when you're a bass in Southern Gospel, you really have to have that more sharp tone in order to be heard. Tim Riley has an amazing sound, and it's really fat. Not only does it have cut, but it's really big as well, and you can hear it right here. If you want to check out more of Tim Riley's sound, check out God's Building the Church, Gold City, as well as I'm Not Giving Up by Gold City. Well, we've reached my top 5, and here we go. Number 5, Tuca. Alright, we're just going with Tuca. Straight beast. Check out this part of his solo in Rautavaara's Vigilia with the Helsinki Chamber Choir. That's ridiculous. But also on the flip side, he's also part of the a cappella bass community.
That is impossible.
And he's part of Club for Five, which he goes pretty low with the microphone. As well as some beatbox. If you're gonna check out more of his work, be sure to check out Helsinki Chamber Choir, Rautavaara Vigilia, as well as Club for Five, Sassy. Number 4, Thurl Ravenscroft. A bass voice immortalized by all of the works he's been a part of, from Tony the Tiger. To being the bass voice in the Haunted Mansion singing part. And even to the parrot voice in the Tiki House in Disneyland.
I'm show you all a trick now. We're gonna make him all disappear.
Hey there, it's Xander from the morning. I forgot to tell you something. Well, Thurl isn't really known for a cappella, choir, or Southern Gospel. Although he has performed in choir settings before, he's really more so just like the standard of bass, and he's done like voiceover work and whatnot. Just want to tell you that. All right, bye. But probably his most famous work of all time is being that infamous bass voice singing "You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch" in How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are.
A lot of his work speaks for itself. Now, when people think about a bass, they think of someone with Thurl's tone. rich, deep, with that booming chest voice. There's nothing like it, really, as far as bass tone. However, that's where my top three comes in. Straight monsters, Inhuman. In the time that I've listened to music, these three guys stick out the most. And, you know, there might be bias, but they're all octavists. And we're starting off with number three. It's funny, because number three rhymes with his name, Mikhail Zlatopolsky. Bars.
Let's go.
Okay, that was kind of cringe, but he was the most loudest bass in the world. And probably the lowest of all time as well. If you needed someone to cover a 40 plus, 50 plus, 60 plus choir by himself, Zlatopolsky would be the one that you'd hire. There are countless videos and audio where you can hear just this one guy projecting over the entire choir, sometimes a little bit too much. But regardless, he's an amazing voice. Monstrous tone though, but he's also extremely versatile with his range. There's a story of when there were a whole bunch of singers of a young age, you know, just the youth in the choir, messing around and showing off just like how younger people do. And so Zlatopolsky had to show them what's up. So we went into the middle, then he sang a G4, a G3, a G2, and then a G1. What is this ridiculousness? But yeah, that's Zlatopolsky, pretty much the most powerful guy that you could find. If you want to check out more of this beast, be sure to check out Thy Mystical Supper by Lvov, and Gurchinov's Passion Week, which was recorded wonderfully by Chandos, and that's like 13 songs, so pretty much a banger. Having to choose between these last two was extremely difficult, because these guys, these last two, were on a different level of, like, bass. But I had to make a decision. And so my number two is Glenn Miller. No, not the big brass band Glenn Miller, but the big brass sounding Glenn Miller, the basso profundo. Seriously, this guy has some power. And not only that, it has bass to it as well, kind of like an organ. So, not only does he have power and bass, he also has perfect pitch. And for those who understand, his voice, his overtones create perfect fifths with his voice fundamental. That's crazy. And unlike the other two in the top three, he still is alive. And that means he still has time to grow and become better as a basso profundo. Who knows what time will tell, 3+ years from now? I'm sure he's gonna become number one in due time. Hey there, it's Xander from The Morning. I forgot to tell you about songs to listen to from Glenn Miller. I would recommend In the Mood. I'm just kidding. Songs to check out from basso profundo Glenn Miller include his solo from Do Not Lament Me, O Mother by Patron Institute Choir. I would also recommend his singing on Bortnianski's Beneath Thy Compassion. And finally, at number one, Vladimir Pasyokov. Now this guy, oh my goodness. Some of you might be wondering why this dude is number one. I think this clip speaks for itself. No, that clip is not pitched down. That is just Vasyukov. You know, when most people think of a bass nowadays, they think about Avi Kaplan or Jeff Castellucci. But something like this is not something that comes to people's minds because this is just inhuman. Now keep in mind with this guy is that there's no microphone. So the amount of bass he's producing is simply from the acoustics of the church and his voice. And there's something about his voice that is just so magical. And in fact, Vladimir Pasyukov wasn't the most skilled musician by any means. His first job was being a woodcarver, and he was beast at that. You can see the pictures. Now his notes weren't always on pitch, but the resonance and the feeling behind his voice is why I gave him number one. Oh, hey there. It's Xander from the morning again. I forgot to tell you songs to listen to from Vladimir Pasyukov. Definitely check out We Praise Thee by St. Petersburg Chamber Choir. And another favorite of mine would be the fifth movement of the All Night Vigil by St. Petersburg Chamber Choir. Well, that's my list for today. Drop your top 10 list down below so I can see what you think. I'll see you later. Peace.